This is down here.
Oh, wait.
Bill, do we have a sheet for that? With what? With the, with the finance committee when we approve the transfer of the funds?
Yes, I get that. You're talking about.
What we did.
Yeah.
You know, we did, when you, you know, that transfer of the funds.
You do that in committee.
It's weird.
You went big time.
Come on, man.
Good morning. Welcome everyone to our April 19th police jury meeting. Mr. Bill, could we have the roll call?
Mr. Stewart.
Here.
Mr. McCormick.
Here.
Mr. Ruffin.
Here.
Mr. Spankin.
Here.
Mr. Davidson.
Here.
Mr. Garson.
Here.
Mr. Spogado.
Here.
Mr. Ebar.
Here.
Mr. Bird.
Here.
Mr. President, all jurors are present. We have a floor.
Thank you. Mr. Ruffin, would you lead us in prayer and Mr. Ebar in the plea?
Let's pray. Gracious Father, we thank you once again for the opportunity to come and serve. We pray a special blessing on this meeting it could be the things in heaven in your sight. Father, we feel a special blessing on all of our members and our constituents that we serve. Bless our national state of government. We ask you to bless in Christ's name.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Moving on, number, need to amend the agenda. No amendments.
Make a motion to accept the agenda.
I second that.
Motion by Ebob, second by Bird to adopt the agenda. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. Right now, we allow time for public comments. Have any public comments?
Hello?
Is it working?
Oh, cool.
So first off, let me thank whoever put this AV system in. I think this is great, particularly for people like me who have hearing issues and other people like Mike who have speaking issues. One of these days I'll be able to hear what he says. So anyway, thank you very much for that. I appreciate it. So I'd like to comment on item 39, which is a greater work in Ward 3. But I don't know if my comments would really be right now. So I don't know. Would it be okay if I wait and comment after I hear what Bobby's got to say about that? I can do it now or wait.
Yeah, let's do your public comments now.
Do it now?
What item is that?
39.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, well, and again, if I say something wrong, I apologize because I don't know what you're really going to say about the greater work. So as far as the greater work, I think we need a lot more work on ditches and culverts. I see where a lot of that's being done. I think that's great. Thank you for doing that. But I think we need more of that. I think we need greater work to put crowns on roads. Maybe we could do a little bit of improvement with that. I think that'd be a good thing. Overall, I think it's good. Thank you for doing that.
Thank you
for filling that big hole in, by the way. Y'all got right on that. So, anyway, that's good. I don't know if y'all saw a picture of the big hole. But anyway, one thing I would like to suggest, I think that maybe the timing of the greater work could be a little bit better, specifically on roads that are being blacktop now. I think it would be better if we made sure the ditches and culverts were clean and the roads were graded with a crown on them before the asphalt put down. And I know you've got a lot on your plate. So what I would like to suggest is we consider adding a road inspector to the road crew. And that road inspector would be his or her responsibility. to inspect the roads before the asphalt, make sure that the prep work's done correctly, make sure that the ditches and culverts are clean, make sure that they're graded with a crown, all that kind of stuff before the asphalt is put down. And then once work starts on that, that road inspector would be able to do things like measuring the temperature of loads coming in, make sure that we don't get some cold mix on, be sure the mix is correct, be sure it's been put down at the right thickness, all those kind of things. So anyway, I'd like to suggest that we add that, and I'd like you to consider maybe make a recommendation to the police crew at the future meeting. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
What you do right now?
Who's ever next? Who's ever next? Who's ever next?
I can't really tell who the singer's on.
I
Good morning, y'all. And I really don't have a lot to say, but I'm going to repeat myself, Mike. I am in opposition to the gag rule. It was demonstrated right there. We want to talk about that grading thing when you're talking about it, not now, for we know nothing about it. That demonstrates the lack of communication between the constituents and this police jury. I recommend that you rescind Mike's gag order immediately. It is a disservice to the citizens of this parish. It is in opposition to the Constitution of the United States of America. Please, do the right thing and rescind your stupid gag order. And I have no problem with the 5 minutes. I don't really need 1 minute. It's that you are not letting us discuss the agenda items when they come up.
Good morning, my name's Rebecca Stigemeyer. I've never really needed a microphone. I'm speaking on public comments, the Constitution of the United States. And again, I agree that gag rule is probably one of the worst decisions this nation has ever made. A year ago, a bad decision was made by Jeff Davidson to mill up several roads in the parish with no plan in place to repave them in the near future. This bad decision could have been stopped by the road supervisor or even this police jury. That fateful decision created a domino effect of one bad decision after another, resulting in one of the most tumultuous years any police jury has probably ever seen in this parish. And all of it could have been prevented. There were many opportunities for this police jury to step up and do the right thing, admit the mistake, stop repeating the mistake, and heed our requests for parish-wide road standards for major road repair and plans for all major road work. We repeatedly asked that no more roads be built up until the ones that had been prematurely milled had been at the very least remediated to the original state they were before the milling. This request was met with excuses and lies. Oh, we can't work on that road. It's not in the order of the list, which we know that list means nothing because you've worked on roads all over this parish that were not on the list. There was promises of remediation only to be remade on. Further milling of roads all over the parish, causing many citizens to have expensive auto repairs, flat tires, broken axles, collisions, etc. Instead of listening to the citizens and accepting the help that was offered multiple times at no cost to the parish would have solved a lot of these problems. Instead, this body doubled down, making one bad decision after another, even to the point of one of your fellow jurors using police force to block us from participating in a library board meeting.
You know that's a lie.
That is not a lie. And in the gag rule.
They know it.
So you instituted a gag rule to try to silence the citizen. This is a continued violation of the civil rights of the citizens. This is an election year, okay? I made all of you a promise, except for the two that did not vote for it, and Mr. Ruffin was not up there at that meeting, that I would do everything in my power against any of you who tried to silence the citizens. And I keep my word. If I give somebody my word is my bond. You can take that to the bank. And I've done that. I've kept my word. Start live streaming the meeting. Roll that beautiful bean footage. If you haven't figured it out, that's exactly what I'm going to continue to do. As a matter of fact, the actions have made my job easier. The fine people in this parish deserve better. They deserve elected officials who will be fiscally responsible, accountable for their actions, truthful, and above all else, uphold the Constitution of the United States of America, which each of you swear to when you swore in as a police jury. You may have thought we would just go away. I have said time and time again, if you had not tore up my road, you never would have met me. You brought trouble to my door. I didn't come down here bringing trouble to yours. And when I asked for help, I was dismissed. You don't know the difference between good road and bad. Oh, we can't do that. So I'm going to tell you, I will never stop advocating for the rights of the citizens in this parish. No citizen should ever be subjected to the reprehensible treatment from some of these police jurors that me and my family have been treated with this past year. Do the right thing. Step up. This is an election year. We're not going away.
But the roads in Yellow Pine is atrocious. Like this gentleman here, I think is over our road. And where they have used to have pavement, most of that stuff is broken off. Now it's just leaving gullies across the road when it comes to big rain. Because we don't have no ditches. They don't know what it is to dig us a ditch. If they do, come in there and call themselves digging a ditch, is maybe 2 or 3 inches high, just for a little stream to run down. Then they come in there, they put peat gravel on the road. Come a big rain, they all in the ditch. So why don't you all come in there, take some, scrape that old cement that's on the road, it's not even 2 miles of road. Scrape it up, send it somewhere, have it crushed up, and come back and put it on the road. That would save you a penny or two. Then come back and fix us some ditches. And the covers that's at our home, we don't have them no more because the ends of them mostly mashed down where the water can't drain through. Or either the water is standing in our yard making potholes and gutters going into our home. Now this don't make no sense. Sabine Parish get a lot of money. And I know our roads in Yellow Pine could be a whole lot better than what they are. We even got a church in there. And by the time you get to that church, you sleep. Because you know, reeled and rocked all the way in there. And these roads is not even worth driving over. I get tired of the wear and tear on my car. Every other 6 months, I got to have a wheel alignment or something. So I hope you all do better about our road. Put up some covers in there. Come in there and put up some covers in there to our home. So the water won't stand in our driveway. So the water can drain down the ditch. And put, please, for God's sake, put somebody on that grave who know how to dig a ditch.
My name is Lauren Pisoni. I'm a registered nurse and I'm a retired professor from that East. We have a place that's out by Big Bass, and the reason I'm here is I'm trying to get more of our community to get together to talk about the roads. The roads are broken. Yeah, we don't have anything that I tell you what I am, my profession, because I don't want to tell anyone how to fix the roads because I don't know how. All I know is how to be a registered nurse and hopefully save some lives. But I'm concerned about the roads at night when people are going down there because there is, we don't have any of that asphalt. We have, it's dirt. And then we've got mud. And already, I've already experienced once or twice when the mud got so thick that I shimmied off the road and went down into the ditch in my car. So I'm asking for your help, mainly with the Big Bass area from Big Bass all the way back to Wanda Acres. We try to go up there and enjoy ourselves. It takes me several times to be able to get back there, you know, and many of our guests, you know, they have so much difficulty too, and so that is much of a concern for us, and I thank you for your time to let me speak.
Thank you.
address, number 29 on the agenda. It's the abandonment of the public use area between lot 3 and 4. Both neighbors have already agreed to a division, and we've already had Doug Dawkins go out there and look this over. Mr. Dean had this abandoned years back, and it was never recorded. So now that Ms. Dean is selling the property, we are running into the problem where it was never filed. So both neighbors have been maintaining this property as they divided it years ago. We just now need it to be abandoned and filed. And that's it. And I do have the surveys and stuff if y'all need to see those.
What was your name, ma'am?
Kara Harrison.
Okay.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Well, we got the info. I imagine Bob and Peter.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
I wanted to ask the jury if next month if they've had a discussion on the closing item, the water sale coming up on the 3rd of January. Parish, the jury is going to have that put up for parish-wide election. How are you going to decide whether or not this?
Okay. Thank you, sir. Any other public comments? Moving on, item number 8.
You want me to ask?
Yes, sir.
Building and all that. So concerning that, the question about water sale, is that ours or is that the river's part?
I really don't know.
Once we did,
as long as the lake, I feel approved.
Once, before, when the water sales came up, that was the river part. The jury did not. Now you saying what?
Now they saying the jury, police jury, along the lake.
The jury can't do it individually. You can't do anything unless they come around here.
That's what happened. Being a member of the SRA.
Right.
We don't even have a contract on that. It's a lot of discussion needs to be done. But once there's some kind of agreement and we understand everybody's concerns, once that agreement is agreed to by the SRA, then it has to go through several approval processes. One of them is to get all the jurors along the river, like Jeff said, and they approve it. Next thing, it goes to the legislature, to the governor. So it's a process that continues on there.
Ultimately the Sabine River Park.
Yeah, they're going to be the ones that ask us to approve.
Okay.
We don't have to get into discussion.
That's what he's trying to do. Same place as one of
the
other.
Okay,
I'm good.
Item number 8 is Representative Shamahorn. Does he have anyone here? No. Number 9, Planning Commission. Mr. Newby. Good.
I just basically came here because right now there are a few things on the plan. There's some states that let the local developers develop on that. And also for item 29, the state area.
Okay. Thank you, sir. All right, next we need to accept the minutes of the previous regular meeting held March 15th, 2023.
Make a motion to accept those minutes.
Motion by Ruffin.
Second.
Eric. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. Number 11, Mr. Cedric Floyd, introduction of an ordinance to merge and consolidate precincts based on the Louisiana Revised Statute 18532 and 18532.1. Mr. Cedric?
They coming for you.
Well, I feel about them, but I'm not even thinking about them. that way, anybody can review, and it's gonna be advertised in the paper. All we do is reduce the number of toll places, we say, from 50,000 to 30. That's gonna help us with tolls, and help us in terms of organizing the precinct, and it's gonna be easier for people to put the bill. Anyway, thank you, like I said, thank you for the vote, what, well, because y'all will have to adopt it, and at the next meeting, you adopt the polling place, and the polling place will not change. So you'll get what they need to be.
Thank you, Mr. Floyd.
Yeah. I mean, I just want to say.
Once he's through. All right, guys. Thank you, Mr. Sedgwick. I want to introduce an ordinance to establish and merge precincts consistent with the 2022 Sabine Parish Police Jury Districts in accordance with the Louisiana Revised Statute 18:532 and 18:532.1. Now, you want,
yeah,
Zach?
Zach, could you tell us which one, where they're gonna be now?
No, the polling places hadn't changed.
That's what I was.
The polling places hadn't changed. They still.
Polling places are still.
Yeah.
Just different people will come to a different place now.
Some.
So we're gonna continue to use it, everybody will have the same polling place.
Yes.
So it won't be necessary for our constituents. They're gonna be voting at the same place.
Same polling place.
Right.
Now, some may move from one to the other. You know, but you're not opening up no new.
All of mine gonna be coming to one place.
Yeah.
So we're, it's gonna be coming upon us to make sure that my constituents are aware.
Well, they probably, even though they were in different precincts, they probably voted at the same polling place anyway. True. So, you know. Yeah. So they're gonna be going there anyway, it's just they're gonna be, you know, up there. Okay. Any other questions? Yeah, we just introduced the deal. Moving on. Mr. Cisco Ray, Mr. Jesse Pollard, and Miss Liz Pierre. The Consider a resolution approving a annual payment in lieu of tax in accordance with a term sheet issued by the Northwest Louisiana Finance Authority to Hollis Creek PV ILLC. Mr. Cisco, how you doing, sir?
Good morning, everyone.
We're good.
I'm representing Hollis Creek PV One, Cisco here. Mr. Hadman is all around the pilot.
Been a lot of talk on this in the past, and I think it's a good for us to carry with it. I think we have all the details worked out, and we're ready to go on to what we need to do. We need to do what we need to do.
Any other questions?
I got a question here on the option to purchase item there in the term sheet. Companies should have the option to purchase the project from the authority for a purchase price of $1,000 at any time upon payment in full of any amounts that are actually in due, owing, and or past under the lease. What does that mean there?
It would essentially mean that you're purchasing the back of the Northwest Louisiana
assume that then the regular full property taxes would go into effect at that point.
And for the general public, this is a solar farm that's coming to Sabine Parish, in case any of y'all was curious of what it is. It's a solar farm. Yeah, y'all have. Okay.
The resolution approving an annual payment in lieu of tax in accordance with the term sheet issued by Northwest Louisiana Finance Authority to Hollis Creek PV One LLC. Whereas Northwest Louisiana Finance Authority NLFA is statutorily authorized local public trust permitted to acquire and hold property for one or more of its public purposes set forth in RS 9-23-2341B. Upon acquisition by NLFA, such property is declared for purposes of RS 9:2347N to be a public property used for essential and governmental purposes, and such property is hereby exempt from all taxes in the parish. The state of Louisiana is the state of any political subdivision thereof, or any other taxing body, and whereas NLFA has arranged to acquire a solar photovoltaic facility, solar project, and potentially an optional energy storage facility, an optional energy storage project, and together the solar project, the project, and in the parish of Sabine, the parish, pursuant to a term sheet issued to Hollis Creek PV One LLC, the term sheet, which is attached here to as Exhibit A, and incorporated herein, and whereas NLFA intends to lease the project to Hollis Creek PV One LLC, the leasee, a limited liability corporation organized and existing under laws of the state of Delaware, qualified to do business in the state pursuant to Louisiana Revised Statute 9:2347N, and subject to the approval of the Sabine Parish Police Jury, the governing authority of the parish, and the approval of the beneficiary of the NLFA. The NLFA will require the leasee to pay annually to the parish and municipal taxing authority, and to any other tax invited to parish through the entity responsible for collecting everyone's taxes. For each tax invited, collectively the tax collector, the sum in lieu of everyone's taxes and the amount not to exceed the amount of taxes that would otherwise be used if the project were not owned by the authority, pilot, in accordance with the term sheet, in order to compensate such authorities for services rendered by the entity to the project, which sum the tax collector shall collect and enforce payment in accordance with the special provisions of Louisiana Revised Statute 39:1002 of statutory imposition, and whereas the term sheet provides that the cost shall commence upon the conveyance of the project to the authority to terminate 11:59 p.m. on the last day of the 240th month after commencement, the pilot termination date. That full avalon taxes will be paid to the tax collector following the pilot termination date. And whereas, as an independently existing public court authorizing the power under chapter 285 Louisiana Revised Statute 1950, as amended Louisiana Revised Statute 9-2341 to 9-2347 inclusive of the Act. A pilot for the project may be required by NLFA only if Sabine Parish Police Bureau has governing authority within those boundaries of the project is to be located and approved by resolution. The pilot for the court of Louisiana Revised Statute 9-2347 inclusive. Now therefore be it resolved by the Police Bureau of the Parish of Savannah that Section 1, the foregoing whereas clauses are hereby adopted and set forth in the preamble to the resolution. Section 2, the parish is hereby approved the pilot to be paid by the leasee for the project in the amount not to exceed the amount of taxes that would otherwise be used. The project is not owned by the authority in accordance with the term sheet. Section 3, the president and secretary of treasury are hereby authorized and empowered and directed to take forward it any and all such actions that may be necessary to carry into effect the provisions of this resolution. Section 4, if any one or more of the provisions of this resolution shall, for any reason, be held to be illegal or invalid, such illegality or invalidity shall not affect any other provision of this resolution. But this resolution shall be construed in the course as if illegal or invalid provisions have not been contained in any constitutional or statutory provision enacted after the date of this resolution, which validates and makes legal any provision of this resolution, which is otherwise, which is not otherwise invalid or legal, shall be deemed to apply to this resolution. Section 5, this resolution shall immediately take effect upon adoption. Need a motion and a second.
Motion by Mike.
I'll second it.
Second by Stephen. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carried. Thank you. All right, moving on to 13, authorize advertisement for bids for the excavating of cells 8 and 9 at Sabine Parish Sanitary Landfill.
Red has prepared the plans for the excavation. We're going to break it into two parts. One's the excavation, the other is the actual construction of cells 8 and 9. This is just for the excavation portion of it. We need to pass the resolution. The resolution is, whereas Mayor Engineering has completed the specifications and contract documents for the excavation of cells 8 and 9 at Sabine Parish Sanitary Landfill, and whereas the engineers would like to advertise the bids on May 3rd, 10th, and 17th, 2023. Now therefore be it resolved that Mayor Engineering is hereby authorized to advertise the bids for the excavation of cells 8 and 9 at Sabine Parish Sanitary Landfill. Motion and second.
I'm going to get motion.
Okay. Second.
Motion by Ebaum. Second.
Bird.
Who was it? Bird.
No, it was Lee.
Bo. Bo. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carried. Okay, item 14 is ratify open the three bank accounts for the 2023 landfill revenue bonds.
Okay, we got our funding for $6 million for the expansion of sales 8 and 9. And I need a resolution ratifying the three accounts we had to open to get some transfer before a meeting. We've opened them, and so that's why we need the ratification. Whereas the Sabine Parish Police Jury has finalized the issuance of $6 million for Series 2023 landfill revenue bonds for construction cells 8 and 9 at Sabine Parish Sanitary Landfill, and whereas the Sabine Parish Police Jury was required to open three new bank accounts for deposit of funds relating to the bonds as follows: 2023 landfill revenue bond operating, 2023 landfill revenue bond sinking fund, 2023 revenue bond reserve fund. And whereas these accounts were open to facilitate issues of the bond, now therefore be it resolved that opening of these accounts is hereby approved and ratified.
Make a motion to adopt that resolution.
Motion by Mr. Ruffin.
Second.
Second by Mr. Byrd. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Item 15 is award contract for landfill gas collection system. Sabine Parish Police Jury has requested proposals to provide renewable energy recovery at the sanitary landfill. Proposals were due by March 31st, 2023. A committee was formed by President Sepulveda to review and rate the proposals received.
There should be a sheet in our package that shows points awarded to each respondent.
Did the committee meet? What do you recommend?
We met with Mr. Pete Tureen and with our engineers, and me and Mr. Stephen was part of that group, of Mr. Weatherford, and we went through all of the RFPs and rated them as recommended, and saying that this was that Gage Renewables come out on top of our list scoring system that we've done. So that's the recommendation from our committee and from everyone that was on the committee.
I make a motion to accept the recommendation of the committee.
Motion by Ruffin. Second by Mike. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
I'd like to say that's a good thing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, 16. Adopt a resolution authorizing engagement of council for the purpose of negotiating the purchase of Sabine Parish property and or expropriating the such property for public use, namely to expand existing Sabine Parish landfill.
What we have is, as we all are aware, those two parcels of land that we're trying to acquire the landfill and go to expropriation. Attorney requested us to do a resolution as to hire for his file. This is what it says. The following, whereas the police jury requires counsel for the purpose of negotiating the purchase of Sabine Parish property and or expropriating such property for public use, namely to expand the existing Sabine Parish landfill, and whereas the police jury does not have counsel on staff, Sabine Parish District Attorney's Office has advised that he does not have civil experience with expropriation actions nor sufficient resources to promptly assist with those matters. And whereas the police jury proposes to retain the following outside counsel for these purposes, the following legal rates: J. Chris Gillette, Cochran, Cruz, Gillette, Johnson, $250 an hour; Mark Vignay, McCoy, Roberts, Vignay, $250 an hour. These attorneys have had experience in commercial matters, property evaluation, representation of parish government authorities, and appropriation. The police jury does not anticipate paying for victim service, rather both of these lawyers or the practitioners and small firms that shall associate with one another for the purpose of property dividing the task, and in this case, to move the matter promptly, similar to a matter which associates with operating a large firm. Whereas the hourly rate shall be $250 because both of these counsels have more than 20 years experience in the practice of law with extensive commercial and real estate experience, as well as extensive trial experience and experience representing public bodies. This rate is equal to or less than typical legal rates in the area for comparable legal work. And direct returns of the October 4, 2022 through completion of the purchase of the expropriation of the property necessary to expand the management of the buildings in Sabine Parish. And whereas the scope of the legal representation does not involve federal claims, and whereas this resolution shall take effect immediately, therefore be it resolved that Sabine Parish Police Bureau, pursuant to Louisiana Revised Statute 42262, after law, is hereby returned to retain and employ the law firm of J. Chris Gillette and Mark Beaton, the special counsel, and be it further resolved that this resolution proposed contract describing him to submit to the Attorney General for the state of Louisiana for approval.
I make the motion because, and primarily, the key thing here is our legal representative, the DA, is recommending that we do this because if he's all the personnel, then I make the motion.
Motion by Mr. Ruffin.
I'll second that.
Second by Stephen. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? All right, next we're going to authorize advertisement of bid for the purchase of a 2023 year model or newer excavator for the solid waste landfill. Solid Waste Committee met March 31st, 2023. Mr. Pete Shireen, superintendent of the landfill, reported that mud sales have increased significantly at the landfill and that he is renting an articulating truck, dirt truck, and an excavator solely for work related to the mud. He informed the committee that renting these two pieces of equipment costs about $19,000 per month. The Solid Waste Committee makes the recommendation of purchasing the needed equipment.
Why are we up for 2023 or new year? Why are we saying that new? Now you can get some good, equipment out there, y'all. I mean, say 21 model, it's good equipment, way cheaper. Well, I mean, I know, but excavator, Mike. I mean, I'm around them all the time. I mean,
Yes, sir. I was trying to find my notes on the meeting, but Pete, if you hear, yeah, you may could answer that. I was looking for my notes.
Why couldn't we go with a little older model, what I'm saying? Get a cheaper, how good the machine is. I mean, all I'm saying, this is suggesting like Hunter, if they had any good,
If you get one like that that's a couple of years old, what about the warranty you get on that? That's what new. kind of warranty you're likely to get if it is a couple years old. You got that frame.
Well, you're gonna get that warranty on the boom and stuff and the frame and all. You're gonna get that. It may have still come.
It's gonna be it's on that lifetime.
Now, I'm like Pete, probably gonna throw that same 12-month warranty on.
What about if we back down to 2023, 2022 year a little bit more options?
And you may get out there and tell people prices, and you may find out they ain't got one. I mean, equipment's a hard thing right now, so they may not have a use in them, and they go like that.
So, well, when we advertise this, we might put it.
Whether it's a new one or used, you got to stipulate.
I mean, how do you, if we get this, or we want to use it, how do you evaluate it? You say we might get a new 2022.
The only thing you could do is really just check around and see what's available. If there's one a couple of years old, see if you can find one like that. But if not, you just have to go and advertise for a new one. And that's just a matter of making some calls, isn't it, Pete? To see what's available out there.
Yeah, I mean, it has to be a good user. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I mean, it would have to be, but I mean, I was just saying, I mean.
And I think one of the issues we talked about too, if we get a newer machine, you're going to get the service from those dealers to come out and do your service for you. You know, with something that you just go and, you know, buy from someone, you're not going to get that. I don't think. And that was one of our concerns. And with this new one, and with this new one, you know, there's probably an option to get an extended warranty, some type of extended warranty package with it. I don't know what it is. Haven't we purchased that before? Like a 5-year warranty on certain things, and it's come in handy. I want to say we've done it on that dozer, wasn't it the dozer deal? We had to use that. Yeah. So. It's whatever the pleasure of the board is. We want to just put you got to have a year, doesn't it? They changed it, made it a 23.
Yeah.
Anyway, I mean, it's.
I make the motion that we advertise the bid for a new excavator.
Motion by Stephen. Second by the E-Bar. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Aye.
I think it's good to make sure that we all aware that the landfill is generating funds for these purchases.
Yes.
That's why they got to have the equipment.
That's very important.
Okay, on moving on, if there's nothing else on this, we're moving on to 18. It's to authorize advertisement of bid for the purchase of a 2023 year model or newer articulated hauler for the solid waste manager. The solid waste committee met also on the 31st. Mr. Pete Shireen, superintendent of the sanitary landfill, reported that the mud sales have increased significantly in the landfill. He is renting an articulating dirt truck and solely for work that is related to the mud. Like I said, it's about the same, you know, as part of the $19,000 per month we're doing so. That he's in need of this articulating truck too. That's what I can haul it from point A to point B. So.
I think we have committee agreed that one is needed. I would recommend that we do the same thing we did on the excavator.
And like I said, I don't know if it may be months down the road before you can find anything like this. So, anyway, do I have a motion on this? Motion by Eric. Second by Mr. Bird. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Y'all want to tell y'all one thing? It's a done deal, but on that situation, we just missed out. By not shopping, by not really listening to people, I don't get it. But y'all, they just cut apart all that equipment for it over here. Articulate what? Duct hooks and everything. We need to keep our eyes open about that kind of equipment. So we're working a landfill now that they scrap iron. They cut it apart for cutting it.
When you put it in?
Yeah. And it was for sale. It was for sale. It was on the internet site for sale. But the problem with that stuff is it's such big equipment that shipping was going to cost people so much money to get it shipped. I mean, they were getting it dirt cheap, but it was costing them much to get it shipped.
Do you know why they had to point it in
there? Yeah. Well, I didn't know we were looking for it. I
didn't know we needed to laugh. Well, we didn't know it until it was found out.
I thought it was a shame. I was with a guy last night that they're cutting one apart right now, that articulating right now, that's doing it today.
Okay. To 19, authorize a new position for an additional operator at the solid waste landfill. The solid waste committee met on March 31st. Mr. Shireen, superintendent of sanitary, reported that the mud sales have increased and that at the landfill. He is currently renting an excavating articulating truck to handle the increase of the volume. He requested that a position for additional equipment operator be established to provide an employee to operate the added equipment. The Solid Waste Committee has recommended creating an additional equipment operator position at the landfill.
I make that motion because I talked to Pete the other day on the phone. He was running ragged. He couldn't even talk. He was wide open. I make that motion.
Motion by Bo, second by Mike. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? All right, moving on, adopt a resolution approving the issuance, sales, and delivery of not exceeding $305,000 of limited tax bond series 2023 awards 1 and 2 of Fire Protection District 1 of Sabine Parish, State of Louisiana. You need to read that.
What area is this? Is that
Was 1 and 2.
Whereas Ward 1256 of this morning, the parish of Sabine, state Louisiana, district proposes to receive not exceed $305,000 in the tax bond series 2023. For the purpose of constructing and improving fire protection facilities. For the issuer, including purchasing firefighting equipment, emergency equipment for the issuer, and paying cost of issuing the bond. Whereas the bonds are payable from the pledge of revenues to arrive by the district and related collective of 10.24 mils. Be levied through the year 2028 pursuant to election bill 89-2017. Pledge of revenues to be derived by the district and levied collection of tax of 8.51 mils. Be levied through the tax year 2031 pursuant to special election bill therein. On April 24th, 2021, collected with tax. And whereas at the proper article 6, section 15 of the Constitution, state Louisiana, 1934, is the desire of the police chief to approve the issuance of said bonds in the district. Now therefore be it resolved by the police chief of the parish of Sabine, state of Louisiana, acting as government authority of the parish of Sabine, state of Louisiana, that section 1, in compliance with the provisions of article 6, section 15 of the Constitution, state of Louisiana, 1974, in accordance with the request of the board of commissioners for the 1-2 fire protection district in the morning, parish of Sabine, state of Louisiana, police chief hereby approves the issuance of said delivery of not exceeding $305,000 in limited tax bonds here in 2023 for the district. The bonds mature notice about not later than March 1st, 2029. Their interest at the rate not exceeding 4.5% per annum to be secured by and payable from the pledge of revenue to be derived by the district from the tax. Now therefore be it resolved. Section 2. Neither the parish of Sabine nor this police jury shall be liable in any manner for the payment of said bond. No funds of the parish nor the police jury shall be pledged to the payment thereof. Have a roll call vote under the motion and a second, and I'll call the roll.
Have a motion. Motion by Mr. Ebar. Second by Mr. Byrd.
Mr. Stewart.
Abstain.
Mr. Corbin. Mr. Spink.
Yes.
Mr. Ruffin.
Yes.
Mr. Davis.
Yes.
Mr. Garfield.
Yes.
Mr. Spolka.
Yay.
Mr. Ebar.
Yay.
Mr. Byrd.
All right, ready to move on?
You want to do the next resolution?
Well, you like it. All right, on item 21, we need to adopt a resolution authorizing investment in the Louisiana Asset Management Pool, Inc. That's the LAMP program.
Right. Come on, didn't we do this last?
Yeah, I was about to say we did it, but this is the form they're going to do.
Oh, we got to do it there.
Because I know we, the finance committee met to do this.
This is just for them.
We got to do it the way they.
We need to adopt this so I can send them a copy to fit what they've saved later on.
We got
to
do it their way.
Okay, I make the motion that we adopt this resolution.
I like
that. But this is something that the jury has already approved. We did this last month.
Second by Mike. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
As a matter of fact, may I, let's do this now. All the jurors have a copy. The finance committee met, and all the jurors have a copy of the funds that were transferred. And this is what we're recommending. The jury asked the finance committee to meet and go with the Secretary of Treasury. The transfer of these funds. This is what we've chosen to do. Well, each area you can look at it, we have a copy of it. And it was approved. That's what we would, well, the jury asked us to do.
There's one thing that changed on this reference is the transfer from the bonds, the 2023 bonds, benefit revenue bonds?
Yes.
We can't transfer that money to the land because it's not federally insured. So we have to study and spend state money.
Okay, so that means that in town, 1.4 million, that's the state.
$4 million. Yeah, $4 million, that's the state.
Okay. Okay. And we took into consideration the finance committee did, we didn't want to just completely leave all our local banks anyway. We did leave some funds in, some of our local banks because we want to maintain, participation in our local. But it is incumbent upon us to make right decisions about funds that we have, and that's why we transferred these funds to land because we pay more.
I would need, adopt a resolution authorizing the president to accept and maintain LRSP signs and strapping for Vernon and Sabine.
What's the deal with Vernon? That's just the way it is. Vernon, that's what it's time. But they awarded, the contract was awarded for Vernon and Sabine.
Oh, okay.
I'll make that motion.
So we've been, oh, I'm sorry, so we've been using them already, I assume?
We needed this to complete that project. Who was the motion?
Me.
Motion by Ebar. Second by Eric. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? We have provision that we have a, they come in late after the other bids, but the striping, whether it's solid line or, we have those numbers. Review bids for herbicide treatment for selected roads and award contract. Sabine Parish Police Jury advertised for sealed bids for the 2023 roadside vegetation herbicide application until 10 a.m. on March the 17th, 2023, at which time the bids were open and publicly read aloud. 5 sealed bids were received. And on your... Okay.
Okay, the 5 bids on the same ICO was $142 an aisle. IBM Solutions, $150 per acre, which is not responsive to our request, it's for a per mile bid. Manco Vegetation was $155 per mile. Optera Solutions was $160 per mile. And Kenco was $175 per mile.
Why is it selected low?
Just like Mary, I didn't want any.
In a lot of areas, you don't, you want to spray your herbicide around residential areas and stuff, but, on your, roads that, to help keep the vegetation down and to keep the bush hogging highway down, so it just, some roads will get it, some won't, so, but it's whatever the list is turned in for the road superintendent that, actually get it. So.
Did we use one of these last year?
Yes.
We used ESCO?
No.
That's who got the lowest bid.
Didn't I see where they were, they had, they were local? Wasn't it some,
were they Bossier City maybe?
Yeah.
Natchez, Bossier City.
Bossier, that's specifications and chemical they're spraying.
It does work.
Oh, yeah, it works.
If you get the right chemical sometimes, I mean.
I've seen it all.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's.
I think some of them, I thought they put fertilizer in instead of.
Exactly. So that's all I think, the last couple of years.
Chemical.
It works. It is.
It didn't take.
I was reading, I was saying, you know, the last one, it worked. And so we, same mixture here.
What do you think about? What do you think about the, I'm sorry, the 3-year option that, that Edco gave for $125? I discussed that with, some bill maybe I discussed with. And I figure we, let's see what they do this year and kind of see what we get. And then, you know, if it turns out good, we may consider that next year. I just saw it in their letter. Okay.
Or we could even take it and determine it if it don't.
That's why, I guess the specs just said yearly, right, annual? So the specs said annual. I figured we'd try them this year and see, and if it works out good, you know. Right. All right, so I have a motion, was it by Jeff? You take the low bid, do I have a second on that? Second by Mr. Eric. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. Consider approval of a cooperative endeavor agreement with the city of Manny, Louisiana to reclaim, compact, and overlay airport road.
This is just an official document that is needed. The project has already been done, and we need for the record, the approval of this public endeavor agreement. And I make a motion.
Motion by Mr. Ruffin, second by Ms. Bowe. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? All right, motion carries.
Same applies to number 25. Once again, it has not been done yet, but I'm not.
Consider approval of corporate endeavor agreement with the Sabine Parish Sheriff's to provide for 2 deputies to operate security checkpoints at South Capitol Street entrance. Motion by Bowe. Second by Mike. All in favor?
Aye.
The lead county sheriff.
All opposed?
Nay.
Bill, you say we're nay?
Yeah.
Two.
Two. Draft copy to the sheriff.
Do you? Okay.
Got 7. 7-2. Ebob and Garson. Right. 26, to ratify approval of President Ricky L. Sepulveda to sign the settlement participation forms for the opioid settlements with CVS, Walgreens, and Walmart. A national settlement for the opioid litigation concerning CVS, Walgreens, and Walmart has been achieved. A packet of the settlement precipitation form will be sent electronically to Sabine Parish Police Jury. The electronic signature of the president of the police jury was required to participate in the settlement. There will be a deadline of April 12, 2023 to participate in the settlement. Need to ratify that.
I'll make that motion.
Motion by Stephen.
Second.
Second by Mr. Ruffin.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Do we have any idea how that will work out, Bill?
No, I don't have any. I haven't received anything since I met them.
I'm talking about how, on the items that only it can be invested in.
But it's part of the settlement, so it'll be. It's already said, I think it's already accepted. It's already part of it.
So whenever. So once we get that information, we would need this to decide where we want to invest the settlement. All right. Item 27, okay. Consider a loan from the general fund to Road District 18, Ward 1, for motor grader repairs. Road District 18, Ward 1, has a road grader in need of significant repairs, which will cost an estimated $140,000. The district does not have the money necessary to pay for the needed repairs. The Finance Committee has considered the district's request for assistance.
Well, that's something that we consider too, the fund, the loan, in Finance Committee. Mike, would you do the recommendation that we have?
Yeah, we looked at that, and I think this is a good one. He asked to get $140,000. We didn't take the money, we didn't take the money to get out, but half of it, which is around $70,000, we put that towards the grader. The remainder of it, don't come into form of a loan, which will be paid over a couple of years, and it'll be replaced upon. I think we're going to have it in a resolution form. Whereas Road District 18, Ward 1, has a motor grader needing major repairs that will cost an estimated $140,000. And whereas Road District 18 does not have sufficient funds to pay for repairs, and has requested financial assistance from the jury. And whereas the Finance Committee recommends only $70,000 from the general fund of Road District 18. Now therefore be it resolved that the general fund loan Road District 18 is a sum of $70,000, and be it further resolved that the loan will be non-interest bearing and will be scheduled for repayment of 2 annual payments of $35,000 from March 1, 2024 and March 1, 2025.
Before we vote, the voting agreement.
So the 70, so I get no roads done this year, is what we're saying out of that. So the one that was just supposed to be done like in the next week or so is not going to be done. That we've done, that I've done told all these people.
No,
it was just my asphalt.
This is your wish.
That's my wish list.
That's your wish list.
You don't have any roads anymore.
Okay, here's my deal with this, y'all. If it's $140,000 on a used road grader. What is a new one?
3 days. That answers it.
3 days. And I bought it.
What's wrong with the grader? I mean, what model it is and what we have trouble with.
What model aren't they graded by?
What I understood on the grader.
He put $140,000 in an old machine.
In an 80.
I don't see that.
And what I understood on that old machine, though, is that there's been quite a bit of money spent in overhauling parts of the machine. And this $140,000 would be a complete restoration of that machine, almost put it back in a new grader type form.
Yeah, but I disagree with that. It wouldn't be. What? Still dealing with the 1980.
What would you prefer?
I'd like to know what the payback would be.
We took it under.
We reconsider that.
Yeah, we took it under as it was your recommendation for this refurbishment.
Well, I thought,
You know, that's the committee, that's what we thought. If you wanna go a different avenue now, you know, we'll have to.
We got to reconsider, if you're talking about a new one.
Everybody's going. We had, but I've been talking to a lot of people. No, me and Bobby's had all this conversation.
So you changing your mind, maybe, okay.
Mr. Bill, what is the longest you can haul money for a police person? Or
if you've done a lease purchase?
For a bike, if you do a lease purchase, probably do.
5 years, huh? With interest.
I mean, you roll with nothing for 5 years.
Bobby, what all exactly, I know me to talk to, what all exactly is this going to be done?
We're going to the transmission, right now the transmission is about, so we're going to transmission, and then we're also, back when you came back from over here again,
that's good, that's a plus. It's a lot better than.
We can't squeeze on them, because like they.
That's been dealing with them a lot.
I don't see why you need to do that, because this is something that nobody likes to do this, but if you don't have a bunch of an option, you just simply doesn't have the funds. So, good money chasing bad?
So what
we gotta adopt a resolution.
What kind of timeline are they giving us, Bobby? Waiting on today to find that out.
Well, we talked about 2 to 3 months. That thing was very optimistic.
So do you have a grader now to?
Yes.
Okay.
Have you thought about checking with like Connor and different ones if they had a use?
He has what, 2 graders, one he still has.
We got one, but we're working on that.
I make a motion we adopt that resolution. The board is in agreement.
Yeah.
You wind up having to do.
Got a motion by Mr. Ruffin.
Okay.
Second by Mike. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? All right, motion carried. Okay. On the next item, we need to declare certain equipment surplus and approve the sales of equipment through electronic auction, govdeals.com. The road department has certain equipment that is no longer serviced and useful to public purpose. This equipment shall be declared surplus and sold through electronic auction.
What kind of equipment are we talking about?
We have, you want to read that, Bill?
We have a D35 Ford. Yep. We have a Massey Ferguson 393 tractor, a Ford 1989 5000 tractor, and a 6th grade tractor.
We've got the extreme hydraulic motor,
So you think we need to put minimum bids on all of them, or just for some of them? And what on the truck? You said $1,000 on the truck? Those radios probably aren't worth much, huh? Any other discussion on these items? I have a motion.
I'll make the motion.
Okay, Mr. Stephen. Second by Bo. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. All right, item 29 is to consider abandoned property at Acadiana Shores in Ward 5. Mr. Garcia, that's your area?
Yes, sir. I'll let the team come up.
Okay, Mr. Nugent.
This is a boat ramp that has been abandoned by the jury. And back then, the jury didn't bring the boat. So they agreed on it.
Ma'am, you're the neighbor?
Yes, I'm the realtor.
Oh, you're the realtor.
Debbie is the owner of Lot 3. Yeah, and we met with the neighbor on Lot 4.
Oh, everybody signed with him.
Oh, yeah. Everybody, we have Chuck Dawes and the right of the boundary people. Both neighbors are going to sign it.
Boat ramps are coming ahead of all the time.
I'm making a motion.
We gotta do it again.
Bo did, but I.
Motion by Bo, second by Eric. All in favor of abandonment on this property?
Aye.
All opposed? All right, motion carries.
Can you get me the legal description for abandonment?
Good.
You can give that to the valley there.
Should get you a copy of it. Get you a copy of it.
Got other people doing their work for you. I thought you'd be great for a place.
Thank you.
Negative.
Appreciate it.
You ain't hit me out there much, dude.
I'm sorry.
Take the file.
Well, that's probably not going to happen again next week. What day next week do you have to file?
So that's going to be about Friday. Moving on to the next item is adopt a fair housing proclamation. Bill, you want to?
April 11th, 2023 is the 55th anniversary of the National Fair Housing Law of 1968 that prohibits discrimination in housing and declares a national policy to provide within constitutional limits to fair housing in the United States. Principle of fair housing is a fundamental concept and should be available to all Americans. We've been asked to adopt a proclamation. The proclamation is follows, whereas the 55th anniversary of National Fair Housing Law of Title 70 Civil Rights Act of 1968. During the month of April, it is occasion for all Americans, individually and collectively, to rededicate themselves to the principle of freedom from housing discrimination whenever it exists. And whereas the law guarantees each citizen the critical personal element of free choosing a home, and whereas a fair housing law has been passed by the state of Louisiana, and implementation of the law requires the positive commitment, involvement, and support of each of our citizens, and whereas the department and agencies of the state of Louisiana are to provide leadership in the effort to make fair housing not just an idea, but an ideal for all citizens, and whereas barriers that diminish the rights and limit the options of any citizen to freely choose a home will ultimately diminish the rights and limit the options of all. Now, therefore, I, Ricky Ellis, Provost, President of the Sabine Parish Police Jury, do hereby proclaim the month of April 2023 a fair housing month. Resolution.
I have a motion on that.
Just a proclamation.
Motion by Mike.
One second.
Second by Stephen. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. Alright. Next is to consider the lease of parish property for oil and gas exploration. Sabine Parish Police Jury has received several offers for lease of land for oil and gas exploration. The land owned by the parish should be leased through the system of a request for proposal that is publicly advertised.
Okay, what I'm asking for here is a resolution for us to advertise for request for proposals to lease the mineral rights. I've gotten three or four of these. Some of them are not good. So 15% royalty. I've got one here from HTR. Louisiana for $2,000 acre, 20%. In any case, we're going to have to publicly bid and out of request for proposal and let everybody have a shot at leasing the land that the police jury owns in Sabine Parish. And so this is pretty nice, I think. I think Randy could tell you better. $2,000 acre, 20%.
How much?
Yeah,
because some of your adjudicated properties probably won't ever get
And if you put it as a, on a fee, you have to identify those properties, that's going to take months. All of it, and as they come. I'm being, like I said, being what they asked it for.
Or just one particular piece.
Do we have a list of all adjudicated properties?
That's the ballpark.
holiday leave, already for home, for real, 6 days, just more for the ball park, three of us, one side, for the ball park, three of us, ball park. So we got that, don't mean that we still hold the ground, right?
They sent you a letter, they know. If they sent you a letter, they don't know what I think you're going to have.
But we'll see. Get those six, that's when? That's when? Swin, what company is that?
HTR.
I'll get that info, and I'll. That's GEP.
Yes, HTR, that's when?
Yeah. I'll get those numbers of me and Bird to do some investigating, and just kind of check in, kind of see what we got.
So, we'll have to do a resolution to do an RFP for those 13 acres.
I would wait and see, because I probably don't have that, I don't see going through all that.
If we have the resolution, though, and you can say, you can add it to the pension.
Yeah, that'll work.
13 acres only?
Okay, do I have a motion on that? Second by Steven. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? All right, on these next items, we were going to table, what numbers were there, 32?
Six.
We're going to table these items till next month.
Is there anybody here from, like, Manny High that's on one of these teams, the fishing, the band, or anybody like that that's here today? Almost seen? Okay.
Well, what we'll do, we'll.
I want my school board member to be here and our principal.
Yeah.
And neither of them could be here today, so.
I hear that maybe there's a lot of testing going on, so it may be better for next month to show. We'll table item 32 through 36 till next.
Did they do this at school board already? They normally do this.
I think they did.
Yeah. I don't know that they have already, but they normally do.
They normally do it.
Yeah, they did do it at last meeting.
I mean, what are we, would you recognize them or?
Yeah.
I don't know.
We just don't recognize.
Jury had. We don't recognize Little League softball there.
We did one that I remember, but it's our responsibility to recognize it.
They all won state titles. They all ripped, every one of them, like I said, they, I guess I should save it for next month, but all of these teams have represented Sabine Parish well this year. Some of them I saw personally, and you know, I just think it'd be right to recognize these folks and show our appreciation and support for our youth and our parish. And yeah, by next month we may have a couple more to add on, hopefully. They started the playoffs yesterday, and the boys start next week. So, Parish has
32 through 36.
No runner-up, Bo. Just champion.
I like how y'all doing it.
Hey.
Employing girls, they didn't mouth them up. They up this year.
They going to be the team to beat, though. They good. Okay. I got a motion by
Kenneth. I'll second.
Kenneth. Second by Steven. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Okay. All right, item 37. Yes, sir. Come on.
Just recognizing these kids, to me, is just kind of a letdown. Just a place. Congratulations. We can get them a little soccer.
Yeah, we're getting them.
Okay,
you got it.
Okay.
Now, if you want to pay,
just
you want to pay for refreshments, we can have refreshments.
Put it on
here,
my lawn. I'm already paying y'all. Put it on my lawn. Put it on my tab.
Put it on your tab. Yeah.
Hey.
All right, item 37 is to consider appointment of Scott Gowan as Director of the Parish Office of Homeland Security and Emergency Preparedness. Mr. Scott Gowan was hired as Assistant Director of the Sabine Parish Office of Emergency Preparedness effective April the 1st, 2022. Mr. Gowan's appointment was for a 12-month period and expired April the 1st, 2023. The current director of the Sabine Parish Office of Preparedness is Mr. David Davis. He has indicated that he would like to work part-time as assistant director of the parish and has recommended Mr. Gowan to be appointed as director of the Sabine Parish Office of Emergency Preparedness. So I don't know if y'all recall, but last year, you know, he was assistant for year now. Mr. Davis is stepping down, but he's still going to act as our assistant. So,
so if memory serves, we created that assistant position on a temporary basis to sunset at a certain time.
I thought we did just reappointed Scott Gowan as the Homeland Security Director, and David Davis said, I will stay on and work with him as an assistant for a period of time.
Right.
David stayed on. Now it's time to put him as the director and David out.
So what we did is that we created, we agreed to fund that position at $700 a month, I believe it was. $750 an hour, what, for 1 year. And after that, if David stayed on, as I understand it, that would all be paid out of that one salary that's dedicated to it. So the $750 an hour, whatever it was, $1,150 an hour would go away.
And so they would, if the next item passes, then they would split that. Second by Jeff. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Thank you, Scott. Appreciate that.
Thank you.
This is going to be $2,000 a month. It's what they get. It's going to be $2,000 a month. It's what they get.
It's going to be reimbursed anyway. Isn't it?
What David gets.
Yeah.
Consider appointment of David Davis as Assistant Director of the Parish of Homeland Security.
So it's not going to cost the police jury anything, him being the Assistant Director then, I assume? So it won't cost us anything to have him at that position?
Assistant Director.
Oh.
But
Scott, go ahead, come on up, please, sir.
The tower was determined by whatever the grant was. You can only get paid your district, if the director tower or anybody in the county, and so, a certain percentage of the, so if they pay the rest, they go down. Or if you're the percentage of the grant, the amount of the county, so,
But that's the money you get from the state, which gives you that plus $2,000 more.
The federal, we have a federal grant and state.
Right. So you, what they've been getting, he can get $1,000, they're paid to you. Then quarterly, you get reimbursed for the state. So he gets $1,000 in two places.
That's the state, he's paying, not the state, not the federal, yeah, two places.
But we don't, we all, we agree. I only wear it once, that's the rest. Like, that's a, guarantee, like, maybe, I think you pay him like, $3,000 a month, $1,000 a grant, and then $2,000 a month.
I guess my point on this is that that goes into that department, how they divide it up. Kind of, I think.
Yeah, I'm confused.
Yeah, me too. Me too, let me get Sheriff.
Right, so you have a kids' grant with the federal.
Right.
Okay, what percentage of that can be done by? The most that we've been with the sheriff's department. So that amount is set once a year on the way to the tower.
That's the C-SIP, it's like, what you see.
Right, the C-SIP, and the federal, they give you, the most of the tower comes out of that federal. Like, it goes up and down every year, it's all the same, what money is that? Those quarters to, each sheriff's contract.
I thought we had supplemented that for a year.
You're getting out of how much?
$1,150.
Yeah, you paid me $1,150.
That'll go away. Because anytime we mention money now, we mention two positions, that has to be considered for both positions, so.
We're paying him to get in there to take your.
Yeah, we're gonna take some of that tower money and give Dave some money, and all those things.
That's why I say we can't in this resolution say that he's gonna get paid so much, and then it's split. It goes to the tower for that part.
We get $1,000 of paper first. And what?
The director gets it from the police.
And then he gets another check.
I don't know what you're saying, but what I'm saying is that they're looking at splitting that money. That goes to one person, he goes to the department, and they're gonna split.
Okay, so Bill, we're paying $1,000.
Right.
Not the last year.
$2,000.
Today, $1,000 of paper.
Let's verify that.
We'll verify that.
And then
you get Sheriff, and then we pay Scott an additional amount of money for a temporary period of time. That amount will go away, $2,000. That was safe.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if it's $2,000, whatever it is, that, whatever the money is, so that's.
The grant is $24,000, $2,000.
But that's all grant. That's not.
But they get paid for it, but from the sheriff comes out, that's.
Well, what we're doing right now, we're gonna pay $2,000 a month, and then give them a right to do the grant, and they're paid that. And one time before, part of the grant, how we used to do, we went like, a 5.8 expenses. And then they only do it for the salary, and y'all increased them to $1,000, and they paid it. Then basically, he said that it's the whole amount that we pay out of the salary, but then a lesser amount is going for the expenses. But we don't get reimbursed $100 of expenses, I think it's just part of that. Now, quarterly, there's something else that you get $3,600 from the state. And that's how it is reported, and that's also based on the salary. And that's just something that gets another grant that they can tie for, so he gets the addition of what we do.
Well, Sheriff, now that we're going to be having a system in, would you divide up that $2,000?
Well, see, right now, the citizens, we're not getting anything for the citizens.
Yeah.
No, that's if they all out of pocket, either they haven't applied for anything, I'm aware of, we don't get reimbursed for that, that's just proof of something, that y'all.
But historically, I think we had a deficit at one time back in the past.
Oh, hey, when I first saw it was $250 each pay year, it was $500 a month.
But I understood that, we'll do away with that assistance and give that money to the director. So all we're doing is going back to that having an assistant. So I was just wondering how that money would be split, is that something that?
Well, see, before when y'all had this system, we wasn't paying $1,000 a pay year. You know, like, the amount has grown over the years, but it went to $250, then we went to $500, and then y'all had a little leeway that y'all had paid extra before.
I'm not discussing the amount, I'm discussing how it would be split. How do we reimburse them now that we got $250?
Well, I mean, I guess it's just the way y'all been doing it. You would get like the invoice for the director, the $2,000, and then whatever y'all decide y'all decide in the system, we're not getting reimbursed for that.
Well, the system goes away now.
Yeah, that
and this comes out of.
$2,000 he gets.
Is that right, Scott? Is that what you're under the impression that it's happening?
Yeah. Well, I don't. To me, if he's getting.
He wants to pay his assistant.
The man, if he's getting $2,000, he's going to have to show that as long as income tax. Then he's going to turn around and give David something. I don't, to me, if it's an agreement where you get $500 to David, $1,500, however that breakup is.
Well, I mean,
we don't get reimbursed for it. We're reimbursed for it. If we pay the
election. If y'all want to pay $1,000 instead of getting $1,000 for the director.
Scott, go ahead.
Okay, now that's the thing I had a question about. Because you're talking about that 36 that we get in court. My understanding is that for the director, since you're going to be the director, my understanding is that you would get that amount and not David.
It's not for the director themselves.
So you're just going to let him retain getting that quarterly amount of the 33 times?
Not for the director.
Okay, now I don't pay anything on that until we get a check from the state. That's something that we don't pay our time. You know, because like the usual way he does, he brings me showing that amount has been deposited in our account. Then, well, basically what I'm doing is just paying him out. We get the money so the jury's not out of it. Basically, they give us the money and we turn around and give it back.
Any other questions? Another discussion.
No, I guess we're involved in it. I guess with $2,000 a month, I think we're going to have to change the way from that. We're going to decide what that's going to be.
Well,
if
we change it, then we're not going to get reimbursed for it.
Well, he said they're going to get out of all these grants, David's going to get $1,250 a month. $1,250 a month.
That'd be what he agreed.
But that's what they're doing.
That's what they're doing.
They do.
We pay them.
You don't pay one guy and that goes on the income tax.
So, that?
If that's what he.
That's him. He's
the director. If y'all pay that out,
so $24,000, say the monthly $2,000 is going to you, and then the quarterly amount, which is $1,200 a month, will go to David.
I guess what Mike's question is that check will be issued to Scott, though.
Yeah, I guess what that confirmation or that clarification there was that two grants, one of them is going to go to Scott, the other is going to go to David. So they
this all started to get an assistant in to be trained for a year. take David's place because David did the job by himself. So now Scott's capable of doing it. So we got one man that can do the job.
State grant.
Well, from my understanding, David's going to stay on just a little while longer before he goes. I know, I've experienced that. Yes, when we have those emergencies like that, it's tough on one guy. Me and Mr. E. Bob, and I don't know, maybe Mike, we've been part of that when those emergencies come up, and he's overloaded. He needs help. But anyway, the resolution says to consider appointment of David Davis as an assistant director of Homeland Security. So, I have a motion on that. Motion by Mike.
Second
by Stephen. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Aye.
Matt, thank you. Alright. On item 39 is discuss grading work in Road District 9, Ward 3. Mr. Jeff?
Yeah. We, back on November 5th, or April 5th, put in a request for some grader work. The grader ended up, after it finished up down Filter Road, not Filter, Queens Road, coming park on Merritt Mountain, and then went to park on the hardware store for 2 weeks, and Shine Bark Road, and the road was off the bed, and the road across the road were graded in them 2 weeks. And I ended up posting that, and I got a text saying about all these other roads that were graded. Well, I went and rode all of them again last night. We've been riding them ever since the 21st of last month when the requests started coming in. And some of the roads started getting graded last week, and all some of the roads don't even have enough rock on them to grade, but the grader has not hit, I mean, except for 2 weeks there, and hit two roads, and this past Wednesday and Thursday starting work and doing some road work, and one of the areas that supposedly was done and had work orders approved in March 27th through the 31st, those roads got graded this past Wednesday or Thursday. And one of the residents there had to go out and stop the grader and ask about their road because he was leaving without doing their road. And he told them it's not on my list. Well, he turned around and went and graded that road. And then Monday, they were down off a Pilcher that made it to the roads that I requested last month. Yeah, but, and one of the residents had to go out and help the guy turn the grader around on the road. And the roads that are getting graded, there's so little rock on the road, it's hard to grade. The clay is barely touching the ground, and they're full of potholes. And none of the roads down Merritt Mountain, the side roads, were graded. I've been riding roads every day just checking, but I mean, we got this $390,000 grader that's too big for our roads, sitting on the side of the highway for all the residents to see, not doing anything, and calling about all the potholes and the trenches, drainage down their roads, washing away.
Well, that's, That's not my...
I got a smaller, very little fit down the road. I got a thing from the road supervisor told me he had work orders and everything showed that all these roads were graded. And I got this where I rode every one of them last night, and some of them are still not graded.
Well, Jeff...
I'm not a grader, y'all ain't gonna use it down there.
I don't...
Well, I mean, we got one that's, really, you can't turn it around on some of them roads, it's so big. I don't know why it was one graded that big, but...
Mark, road one.
Is that your district, oh, who's your, that's your district?
Mark, road one.
Well, I was going...
Mark, was that, that grader set there for 2 weeks, and that was real tight. Going to go down, everybody gonna realize, we do not have certain places for that grader. And on the first place, most of them is at the end of the merit house, is by the school, the hardware store, and all those roads are graded. That takes into consideration that it has rain in between there. Because that road is graded for that, if it gets rain on it, you're gonna have water washes, going to look like it wasn't graded. Those roads are graded. I know they're graded.
I've been riding them, and I got residents that's been calling.
That grader...
And telling me today, I can show you text messages when the resident sent me, the grader is on my road today.
Okay.
It's been the last few years. The grader has sat more than it was.
Well, sir, that's not right. Just because you go back to that same spot every day, doesn't mean it wasn't wrong.
But it's there all day during the day.
No, sir, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
No, sir, it's not.
Well, all the residents know it, so...
Well, Mr.,
Don't speak for me.
Mr. Hughes, do you have records of work orders for these roads? Okay. All right.
Are they being worked?
Okay. And
the list that they told me was done back last month, on the 12th of this month, Wednesday, last Wednesday, I got pictures and all of some of the roads that they said were done last month, where the graders on the road doing it, and then they went and put a little layer of black rock on top of it. Everywhere in the area, they're adding that little black rock where there's no rock on the road, it's nothing but clay. But they're piling up limestone behind the worm factory. Why not go put it on the road instead of piling it up? Why double work?
Well,
Bobby explained that even on graded lots, if it's done to rain, maybe it's graded against the discount for it. So it's graded after that, I mean, after the second time it's graded.
Even some of yours, Mike, I'm riding those too, down Queens Road, and they go partway down the road, but they don't hit all the other little roads at the end. The main ones that were talked about are still, as of 5 o'clock last night, were still not graded, with epox holes in them, and no rock on them.
Well, if those roads were reported in, I imagine they on his work log to get done.
Well, over a month.
I mean, it is what it is. I mean, you got one grader, you got a man that's been out. I mean, you can only do what you can do. I commend y'all guys that work on our road department. Y'all take a lot that work on that road department, because you only one crew or two crew. I mean, only one person or two people. I know up in my area we have three guys, and two of them stay in a truck hauling all the time. So it leaves the road foreman slash operator to take care of his foreman business and run over and go try to grade something. So, you know, our personnel is stretched. They can only do so much. In a perfect world, we need 5 or 6 workers out there to maintain these roads.
Ward 3 has undergraded over a year. We get one. It should be working every day, trying to make up for everything last year.
But anyway, I appreciate, Mark, I appreciate what y'all do, man. I commend y'all. All right, moving on to the next item.
Make a motion to pay all the food bills.
Motion by Ruffin. Second by Bow. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. All right, Mr. Weatherford, financial report. Oh, I'm sorry.
What do you got? What do you hear there?
I'm making a motion to transfer the sales
tax. Okay, I knew Bo and him was going to do that. Ruffin?
Yep.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? See, I knew y'all was going to take care of that. Now where we at?
41.
Appropriate sales, transfer sales tax for April. Operation $425,000. That was a motion by Ruffin. They fight for it every month.
They kind of ran together.
All
right. 42.
Now we're on 42 committee reports. Oh, we got any committee reports? How's the courthouse doing?
Lovely.
Lovely.
We got our new microphone and TV.
Good.
Awesome. I'd like to call attention to one other thing that we did not mention. We discussed the finance committee met, and we did. We've already discussed three of those things that were on the agenda. We met primarily because the jury had requested that we see about those transfer of funds. We discussed that. Our agenda was amended to include the grader and both, and we discussed that. We also amended to Bill wanted to discuss the software. And Bill asked for a little time, a little more time to see what the other would do. And we all agreed to do that. And we told him that we can't make that decision. The only thing we do is come back to the jury and say that Bill would like to try. Because I guess it's a new
thing now, because I understand a lot of other things that take place. But the finance committee did 4-0 approve granting more time. Am I right?
I don't know if you can't, we didn't have a chart.
What do you mean we didn't have? We did it.
The commissioner as a whole has already said to do it.
Mike, you didn't understand me. In our finance meeting, we amended the agenda to give a group of bill.
He said to discuss.
He did that.
Well, we all agreed to discuss.
And did we, what did you ask for, Peter?
For a different time, for our contract with business.
And all four of us agreed to that.
Agreed to make a recommendation.
Right. And that's all we were gonna do. We couldn't, not to change anything, because we could change that in finance meeting. But the four of us agreed to make a recommendation to the jury that we grant time for him to see something.
That's what the building already been given the task. We had already voted.
Voted on it, we were missing farms on the price.
Bill, the jury voted to change software. Bill came before the finance committee and said, I would like more time. I need to look to see what there's somebody has come up with something, and I don't even know what was, but we agreed because you wanted more time to look at this, and we all agreed, and we would come back to the jury and inform you all that our Secretary of Treasury said he'd like more time to look and see because the other people had done something, huh, Bill?
To me, the way I took that meeting was that we didn't agree to come back and make a different recommendation to the jury. Bill said that there was no time designated in our closing full jury to get this done, and that he said that they had come back and made some other proposals, which we had to look at. We said that's fine for us, but we didn't make any kind of recommendation that we were going to come back to the jury.
I am reporting what the finance committee did. The finance committee agreed to recommend to the jury.
Right.
What did we vote on?
We voted on.
A year, now it's $27,000 a year.
What?
The price went up compared to what
we
voted.
Yeah, but Mr. Ruffin, what they voted.
We couldn't change that. Not in the finance
committee. No, we just said it was okay with us. There's no time limit. There's no time given to implement this.
Bill had requested a little more time to see what the software company was doing. And all four of us agreed, okay, the finance committee will recommend this so this body can make a decision where you want to do something. Am I right? Is that the program? We don't make the decision.
We had already made the decision.
You made a decision to do what?
We had already made the decision to go with the
new. And yes, you did. And Bill came in and said, I would like more time because we had, so we could have rescinded if we thought it was necessary, just like we've done any number of times before. We've gone out and made the decision right with buying a machine.
Oak Hill Road. They already come.
We were buying a machine. And Bobby came back and said, this is not good. So what did we do? We've gone on the recommendations of Bobby. He says, it's not good, let's back out of that. This body is the one that has to make that decision.
And we did. We did make that decision.
Okay.
And software?
You made a decision before the finance committee even come back and make recommendations. You guys didn't even know what we're gonna recommend. We voted in the finance committee meeting to go back before the jury, and we said, now you can decide whether you want to give Granny more time. That's beside the point. But we're recommending that, in the finance committee, we're recommending that the Secretary of Treasury have more time so he can look at the software and see what was available.
Software has been pitifully unable.
That you have to decide that later on. You're making a decision The only thing we do, we only coming to you. You ask the finance committee to look at it. We're coming to you and just saying that, okay, in the finance committee, we'll recommend it. Now, some of you may want to change your mind, because when the finance committee, we said, yes, Bill, we're going to recommend you give more time.
Why did you call me and not call the other people in the finance committee?
Because
you feel like I was an easy ass.
No. You took that wrong.
Yeah, I know. I mean, why,
you took that wrong, Bob.
I'm asking you a question. Why did you turn to me?
Because I felt like I could call Mike and get an understanding of what has transpired. And I may have done the wrong thing.
But it's my understanding, and Bill can clarify that, and I like to speak to him, is that we were saying it was okay with us. We didn't mention going back to 40 years.
And the thing about it is, something.
If y'all granted him more time, how do you not come back to the full jury?
Here was a question.
Yeah.
It was no time. There was no time given in our proposal. We agreed that we would change software. There was no time given on the implementation of that.
Okay, but why? This was voted on, and I.
Yeah,
it don't matter how it voted, it passed.
It passed.
Okay.
It was based on.
But how can y'all grant him more time then?
We didn't grant him more time.
We can't grant more time. The only thing we can do is come back to jury and say.
There was no time limit on implementing, so how can we grant?
Okay, but y'all said y'all were going to come back to us and recommend more time.
Well, it was no time given. If we'd have said in the full jury meeting, you've got a month to implement this, and it said I need 2 months.
If we didn't vote, that's not what we're saying.
Then we'd have come back and asked for more time. But we didn't put in time, so how could we go back and ask for more time when we didn't say how much time we had to start with?
All this was,
Bill says he'd like to look at this, which is fine with us, but we weren't making a decision that changed what the police jury.
We couldn't do that, Mike. We had to come back before the body. We can't make a decision for the jury.
That's what I'm
committees
saying.
Can't do that.
That's what
when
I'm
committees meet every time, you come bring your whatever your findings in your rodent shop, you bring it to this body.
We didn't make a decision.
Okay. But what we're saying, Mike, is y'all told him he could have more time.
No, we said we're okay with that.
Y'all are going to recommend it to us to give him more time.
Well, you did vote on it, Mike.
Give any more time.
You vote on it.
What y'all vote on then?
We was going to make, okay, okay, okay.
Getting the new software.
We had the meeting, we discussed it. Bill come and Bill's thoughts were that software services have kind of stepped up to the plate. And he said that maybe, you know, give me a little more time to kind of see what they got to offer. That was, am I correct so far? Okay, so we said, well, that's fine. So I guess Mr. Ruffin's recommendation would have been at this meeting is to make the recommendation to the full board to give Bill another month with software and services.
So whatever time it is, if it's another day or another week, the jury can decide whether we want to do it.
He said a month. I'm just quote what he said.
So then it's up to Bill to come back and tell us that he wants to stay and get out of the contract with other people?
And so, can I finish? So, in saying that, Bill's intentions were good. It was going to be a little savings there on that deal. But, you know, the board had made the decision to go with Edmunds or whatever that company was. So, in between, it's going to take anywhere from 6 to 9, maybe 10 months before this is even over to this other company. You see what I'm saying? So, to me, just me personally, the month's in there to see what they got to offer. Because the board had done made the decision to move on to Edmunds, or whatever their name is. I can't remember the name. So, it wasn't really no time deal, but I understand Bill's concern. He's seen an opportunity there. Might be some savings and might, you know, might be a good offer for us, but
right. That's the only concern that I have.
And I go
because Bo had that one. Well, first, how much this thing gonna cost us? Well, we did find out what it's likely to cost us. And I hadn't even mentioned anything about that. I wasn't even concerned about that.
Right.
I was the process of going about doing it. and it appeared that we didn't even go through the process. Bill wanted more time to do it. He's, well, we've already voted to do it. Well, Bill can come back and says, I request that you, we've done something different. This body's gonna change. As a matter of fact, and I said it, and I want the record reflect. The only reason we said, let's go with that software, is because Bill came up here and said, we want to do this. We've got a problem with this. We've got a problem with this. I would like to, and I think this jury went along with Bill because he's the man that's running the program. None of us in here, regardless how intelligent we think we are, know more about the software program that they're running in that office than Bill and Cher. And I think we voted on that because he requested it. Yes, he made the recommendation.
This negotiation for this time has been going on for years. I mean, if we don't know what, these problems with this other county have been going on since the past. They never cut up and said we're going to do that. That's just a problem.
Well, now, are you saying that Bill don't know what he's talking about?
Well,
he's the one that came up and said that, Mike.
Let me say what I want. Okay. What I wanted was more time because Software and Services stepped up to the plate. They gave us a tier two or tier one, I forget what they called it, supervisor to personally handle our account. Because I had made it abundantly clear, as y'all well know, the service we got was pitiful. I told them that. They came in and one of the things we were looking for was to have PTO time recorded on our check stubs. They couldn't do it. We agreed and we passed a resolution to go with Evans. They found out about it. When they found out about it, they got off the dead center. Within 2 weeks, they had what we needed put on the check stores. When they did that, they also wanted to talk about what was needed at the road office and get the things, the information at the road office. They had to have time. I wanted to see whether or not they could stand up and do what they wanted to do. They had assigned us, which they never had before, a new employee that was our representative, strictly ours. So the phone number, we call it, we get that person, they address our issue. They've lost a lot of clients because of the poor service. They're trying to work with us. Because of that, I wanted some time to see if they were really going to do what they wanted to do. If they were, I wanted to come back and give y'all that information. My job is to give information to y'all. And y'all use that information to make the best possible decision you can for the benefit of the parish. I didn't think that we had all the information we needed. Had we gotten that information and had we been able to get them to come and look at the issues that Bobby has and correct those, we could have considerable savings. We can always change. We can't now because they sent us a bill for $43,000. To get out now costs $43,000. But had we been able to address that, taking that little bit of time, we might have saved a lot of money.
Well, and that's called competition. All they need to do is hear that you're considering somebody else, they'll do the job.
And it shouldn't be that way.
You don't know that. That's what competition
does.
And they was going to do the same thing time for the same money.
They've had
the jury decided to go with the other. And now,
they've had 2 years. It's been
look,
2 years.
I'm not going to take up for it.
Right.
They gave us
we've had 2 years.
Once you got service, the only thing I say is, the only concern that I have, we hired a man to do that job. In every position that we have on this jury, when we hire people to do a job, we be supportive. We've done that any number of times. We hired you to do the road. Somebody don't think you did it right, but since we hired you, we got to be supportive of you. We have done that, have we not? I see the landfill. When you come make recommendations, we have to go with it because we're not experts in that. We go with the recommendation. When you all come and say, Pete says we want, we try to do that. We have a Secretary of Treasury that's over this, and when he comes and says, I want this,
We gave it to him. If he says, I'd like to have a little more time to look at it, then we say, oh, no, no, we've done that before. We don't need to go that far. This is demanding no. And I think it's reasonable for him to say, well, I'd like to take a little more time. We can save a lot of money. Now, we haven't mentioned the kind of money we're talking about today.
I think we ought to mention that.
It costs $62,000 to insert that new program. Plus, it's going to be $20,000 a year more. Now, that was not the issue because I'm not even concerned. The only thing I was concerned with is the process by which we go about and do it. I think it's... I'll leave it.
And how?
I don't know where about it. But the only thing I did, and I'm not software, I don't... Whichever one you get is fine with me. But then I have to take the recommendation of our Secretary of Treasury. Somebody don't need that. You know more about it than Bill, and he's running that program in there.
But how we got a bill on it, well, to get it okay?
That's a new thing, too.
I mean, how we got a bill if
when we decide we're going to do this, then we get a $42,000 bill.
If we ain't kind of went to the recommendation of the Finance Committee.
In a week's time.
I was instructed to sign the contract as soon as we had the deal.
You was instructed?
Yeah, you instructed into it when you voted.
But it came back. It came back to the Finance Committee. I mean, I thought there was an agreement. I'm not in the Finance
Committee. After the Finance
Committee,
you signed it?
Mm-hmm. No, after the Roden Shop.
I had that.
Roden Shop was landfill.
And they had nothing to do with it.
There wasn't a committee meeting.
It wasn't a committee
meeting. Y'all didn't have a finance. I mean, I'm not in the finance.
We had a meeting that day. I don't remember which day it was.
Who had a meeting?
It was. I don't remember what the committee had met.
It wasn't a committee meeting.
No.
A group of jurors got together.
We was already here in a meeting.
Sure,
none of us.
Said vote.
No.
Yes.
Are you talking about the nine of them?
No, sir.
That's not what he's talking about, Kenneth.
So, you know, and this is the deal.
You put eight in there because I did.
We have an opportunity to get all. I'm not a computer person either. But I know we have an opportunity.
Secretary of Treasury in the face.
But we have an
opportunity. You don't know what you're doing. You don't know what you're talking about.
But we have, okay.
That's basically.
I see your point. I see your point.
Do you understand?
I see your point.
How does this man feel when you do that, what you've done?
But how he could get directed so. When he should have made the call.
Who did you sign this? After a meeting, you got told to sign it?
I was dumbfounded because he said, well, I was told to sign it, and I signed it. What?
We directed him.
No, we didn't do that.
Yes,
don't do that. Bill, when you left out this meeting, did you sign?
No,
you didn't. Come on, Kelly, you know better than that.
It's your job to do what we told you to do. Exactly what you said.
So who enforced it? Who enforced it?
Let me explain a little bit more. Bill gave his clarification. So we as a juror directed Bill by approving that to go with the other contract. We did not say you need to do this week or next week or 3 weeks. We just said, go do it. We didn't put a time limit on it. Bill came to the meeting and told us about some of the changes that software services made. And he said that probably took a month to look at it. We said, that looked reasonable to us. We weren't trying to change something that the full jury had done. Let me finish this, please.
Okay.
We didn't try to change something the full jury had voted on because there was no time limit in there to start with. He could just have delayed that a month without asking anybody. He just wanted to discuss it. So then Kenneth said, no, y'all can't, if y'all voted on that, y'all can't do that because we, as a juror, full jury had already approved him going ahead. He said it's illegal for y'all to change anything that the poor jury has done. And so
but the way to change it, they just didn't do it, Mike.
Well, why we couldn't bring it back to
if
the
you
jury
first said
and
it
do
wasn't
the right
time.
Decision
the
for the time
they come
public.
Back in and start doing their job.
Well, we do it all the time.
We were misinformed.
we were seeing stuff, I mean, we
but the biggest deal is $60,000 plus a $20,000 each year.
More in cost.
And if the jury don't want it, I'm taking it back.
When the old company at that lower price adjusted their stuff to work now.
And well, that should have been Mr. Beal's call to say, look, we're gonna save this amount of money.
Yeah. If Mr. Beal wanted to do that, come back to the jury.
He could have come down that without.
Well, that's what should have been done.
He could have come back.
No, he said he was directed.
He could have come back to forgery instead of going to finance.
Well, that's what he would have done. But it happened before we come back to this board. The way it sounds to me, he wasn't in the finance.
I'm saying that he wasn't under any urgency to put that into action.
You said he was directed to do it, Mike.
Has this contract been signed with the new company?
Whenever we at the police jury agreed that we wanted to go to the new software company, Bill at that time was instructed to sign the contract. So that's the contract we used to do.
That's when you signed.
If he decided at some later date.
Mike, you kicking the ball down the road. That's not what happened.
Get real, man.
That's not what happened. You kicking the ball down the road.
Y'all gonna call this man a liar to his face then.
This man asked for time.
I'm not about the software, y'all.
Come back.
Don't.
I think.
That's like kicking Bobby down the road or something. Y'all gonna do it to him.
Let me say this. I think something was done that was out of order.
It was.
Who did?
What did we do?
You were pushing the issue. The jury says, okay, we're going to go to another software company. Who said, do it now?
Mr. Beal made that request.
Oh, is that what you did? Who said, do it now?
We told him to do it.
No.
We didn't
say you don't have the authority to do that.
We didn't say
you didn't say now. You didn't say now around this table. You don't have the authority to come back. Go outside the room and force that man, just like you know him, tell him how to fix the room. Your authority ends after you leave this, and I think that's what was out of order. When you left this room around this table, you went and made a decision to say, you don't have that authority to do that. Just like Jeff doesn't have the authority to tell Bob how to fix the room. You can't do that. I think you went beyond. That's not what I'm concerned about. I'm concerned about we hired a man to do that, and for some reason, you decided to go, you do this right now. You can't tell that man what to do. He doesn't work for you. He worked for the jury.
He sure does.
He worked for the jury.
I don't have a problem with the software company.
I don't care either. But I think we've never done anything like that. Taking anything under my head like that and going. Now, if you disagree with me, you may be. But I still think Bill is the Secretary of Treasury. I think we need to respect him as that. And if he comes in and make a recommendation, even if you don't agree with it, you can vote against it.
Who's the chairman on the Finance Committee?
I am.
You are. And you made a recommendation, Mr. Bill is okay with it, to come back to you and come to the jury to make a decision?
We voted on it. 4-0.
In your committee meeting.
In the finance committee. We voted that we'll come back to the jury and say, Mr. Bill, ask for more time. Because we can't make the decision. We can't give you more time. We're just a committee. But we were going to come back to the jury. And the jury can decide, well, no, we don't make no time. No, we don't want to do it with that. We've had problems with that before. But the jury has decided.
Well, that was a done deal then.
The whole problem with this whole deal was that you couldn't do what you needed to do with the software too, right, Bobby? That was the whole deal with the new software?
Oh, I don't know about that.
Yeah. I mean, pretty much.
Bobby was wanting the new software.
Is that so?
I understand that. But what you're saying now is after they tightened up, that he's going to be able to do that?
Don't know that. That's what I need time for.
That's what we need time. I mean, so
But y'all voted on time to come back and recommend that we give him more time, but then somebody tells him to sign it?
That's out of order. That's just simply out of
order. Illegal what y'all doing.
That is simply out of order.
That can't be done. That means mind your own. Let's split 5-4 votes.
And if the jury decides 5-4, I don't care the jury still. I'm a part of that. But it has to be done here, around this table.
Well, bringing it to the finance committee, it was my thought that that wasn't what the thing was going to start with. It's still one more time. He didn't have something.
Well, why do we have different committees?
If he wanted, if he needs more time, he can come back to the jury and say, I need more time. Put that on the table.
Well, that's what we was going to do.
Well,
today, but sounds like to me.
Well, why you didn't say that in front of him? You could have said that before you voted. You voted to give him more time. Why you didn't say, I don't think we need to decide that now. And I wouldn't have a problem with that. You voted to give him more time. Stephen, am I correct?
Yeah.
So if you felt that was improper to handle that, why you didn't bring that up at the finance meeting? I wouldn't care. What concerned me is that we sat up there and voted for nothing, and then we walk out of the meeting and do something different. That's not right.
But what concerns me is what individual came to Mr. Bill and put him on the spot to say he.
I don't know anything about that. I was gone then. I had left then. And it didn't happen that same day. It happened after that. It was not a jury decision or committee decision.
I'm looking for answers.
And me too.
The answer is that Bill has done signed a contract that which this board voted on last month. Last month's meeting, this board voted to go with Edmonds. This board did.
On his recommendation.
Now, once he calls software service, they want to step up to the plate on the deal.
And that's where it's
what do you think about that, Bill? What do you feel about that? We're not going to vote on it. But I mean, Seth, what do you feel? How do you feel about software service coming up with all these new things? They're going to do so much better. You think we just disregard that? Or?
Well, that's a new point. Like I said, I signed an agreement to send in. We have to pay a huge penalty to get out of it.
Y'all are all missing the point here. It ain't got to do with software services. Y'all had a meeting, and y'all voted to give a man more time to bring it to us to vote on him to get more time, and somebody went in there and told him to go ahead and sign it. Y'all voted on that. That's wrong. If you're going to vote on it, then bring it to this table.
It does been voted on.
I understand, but then why'd y'all vote on it? Then why'd y'all vote on it again?
The topic didn't come up because he called software service.
We told him. That's what we're trying to figure out.
So it was voted on.
So the committee vote means nothing.
That's my point. Why we got committees? In road committee?
Hey, and when Bill came before the committee.
Wasn't it going to be a recommendation? That was going to be a recommendation.
When Bill came before the finance committee and said, I would like to amend the agenda to include this item, software service, because he wanted to bring us up to date with something. That's why we even talked about it. That finance committee was not to discuss that. We amended the agenda.
Bill said he wanted it on. And by the time the next meeting was going to be on.
And it's going to take several months for this to even happen.
Yeah, but we don't know.
Let's see, when you sign the contract, we can't back out of it if we wanted to. But I mean, Nobody's understanding.
Nobody wants to understand.
Nobody wants to understand our question.
I see your point, but the point is, from the get-go, it was voted right here 9-0 to get the software people to hire the new. We all voted.
Look, we could have changed it.
Yeah, you could.
We could have changed it.
We could have changed that.
The only thing is that it didn't have a date on it. So if we'd have said immediately that day.
Yeah.
So, and all I'm saying is in the future, for no misunderstanding, whenever we vote on something, it's given effective date.
Why it had to be the future? We all grown men. We knew what was right and wrong.
And I'm all in favor of him being able to do whatever he needs to do on the software.
And that's my whole point. I'm not a computer person, but I am going to make this recommendation. That when we do go to this software service, I mean this new software, I want Bobby's staff, I want Bill's staff, everybody that's involved here. And if Stephen, I would like for you to be on that committee. And Mr. Ebob, if you want input, whoever wants to volunteer to be on this software deal, be on it.
For what?
Well, for what? What?
For our new software that we're going to.
What are we going to be determining?
What?
This guy's been here for 30 years and he made a recommendation, or maybe 30 plus years. And y'all, we throwed it out the window and went and directed a man.
No, if you ask me to be on the committee, Bobby, I'm going to say, Bill, what about this? What are we doing here? And if he asked you to get on there, aren't you going to rely on what?
I will.
That's what I'm saying.
But the thing
is, you can't. We are jurors.
Right.
But we have our own expertise. We hire somebody that specializes in that.
But there's also input and discussion on this, on what his office wants to have in this system too, and even maybe the landfill put some of their information on it. Here's the chance to get your.
And then we was going to get all that done with no money changes.
That's all I'm saying.
But we was going to get all that done with no money changes.
I was never aware of any other department.
But Bill, as we at right now, the contract's signed. So. Contract signed.
Well, we
understand that.
But how did he? Who directed him to sign it?
You did. And you did. And you did. And you
no,
did.
No.
You say that, Kevin.
You know better.
No, somebody came in his office.
You can't put this body around it. We didn't do that. We said we're going with another software service.
This is what.
And you were out of order if you sit up and instructed him to do that.
Not instructed to do that.
I didn't think he did. I don't think he would. I don't think he would. Because you know that's out of order.
And you know I didn't.
Yeah.
But let me tell you, you like to say, every decision we make comes around this table, and you're right. And we did instruct Mr. Bill to do it, and it was assumed that he was to do it immediately, and assumed.
Who assumed that?
And like Kay Wall said, you assume. If I tell you to do it, do it.
Who said
it? If I was your Secretary of Treasury and you told me to do it, I'd do it tomorrow. I'm not Mr. Bill.
No.
But I would do it tomorrow. I wouldn't wait a month or 2 months, because it's the same company with the same spots. Not going to change anything that they do. They were just trying to hang on.
I agree with that.
That's your saying.
That's your view. That's your view.
But see, Mr. Ruffin,
Kenneth, we got to listen to what this man's views on.
Well, we did, and we made that recommendation.
No.
And we assumed he was going to do it.
What did you say, Bill?
Which he did.
You said, give me a little more time. I'd like more time. You disregard what the man has requested. I mean, that's like a slap in the face.
This
I'm telling you.
This committee did that. This committee made that.
This committee didn't do that. I think if you went in and told that man, I want you to do it now, and right after he had said, I would like more time to look at this, to see what we have. No. We've never done any of our supervisors that way.
Sound like it's
we have never done any of our supervisors, have we? Have we ever done you that way? No, we have not. We don't do that on this jury.
But that still ain't answering what little question we asked. My question. I mean, who asked Mr. Bill that you gonna sign this paper?
I'll answer that question. As far as I know, it's not an individual decision.
Well, it's more than one?
It was an argument made that the finance committee did something, he needs to overrule in the form here that the direction they ought to do something that the form here had already.
So you said Mr. Bill's lying?
No.
Well, you just said he wasn't directed.
Who made the argument?
You said he wasn't directed.
I made that
this
argument.
This guy said he was directed.
You made the argument that what?
I made that argument that the full jury had decided to instruct him to sign that contract. That's what I
that was the argument that you made. But who made the decision about not giving him more time after he was quit?
Who come back and told him to sign?
Somebody come who shouldn't back. Be allowed I think Bill made the statement, well, I'm gonna, if that's the case, I'm going to go do it right away.
You say you're going to do what? What did
that
make you going to do?
I'm asking. I did, three times. Tell us.
4 years.
Which four?
They don't have the authority to do that. No four jurors don't.
They can't do
make that.
That
decision. This court made that decision.
Did you hear what he just said? Are you just disregarding that? You don't want to hear that. You don't want to hear that you went outside of,
going all
that you
over
went outside of the
y'all
meeting.
Y'all are the laughing stock of this whole dang community here.
We voted to do that. We should have implemented it.
And what happened is you went outside of the jury meeting, the committee meeting, the four jurors, that was not a meeting, and instructed Bill to do that. That is out of order.
And my question is,
you don't think it is?
Why'd you do it, Bill? Why'd you sign it then if only four told you to do it?
Well, because the full jury had been...
That was a mistake. That was a mistake. I believe that was a mistake. I told Bill beforehand, I believe it was a mistake, but I think it was more of a mistake for you to take it on yourself to go behind the room and bogart the man and tell him you do it. I think that's what happened. Four of you got together and went up there and said, I want you to do it right now.
No,
that's not right. No. That is not right. And I think the taxpayers should be upset about it. And not because, I'm not even about the money. That's not the way it, that's not the way this jury operates.
It's still four jurors, but we ain't got the name. So we still don't know.
That's not
hard. It's hard for me. I don't know. I ain't got
Well, the thing about it, I think it was out of order. And I'm not trying to sit around there and put my hand on thing on anybody. I think the process was just totally ridiculous. That's not proper in any governmental body. You don't go behind the scenes.
Well, what I'm elected for then? I mean, what I'm sitting here for?
Exactly.
I mean, if I can't make a decision that's going to better this parish, I don't need to be sitting here. If I can't help the people, and if I can't spend...
You made that.
If I can't spend the people's money.
More we go on, I've expressed it. More we go on, I think it gets deeper and deeper. I think it's improper. And we got to do something. We got to live what we got because it's supposed to cost. If it cannot cost, Bill says $40,000 already after a week. I said, how can they charge us $40,000 that quick? Somebody had to be informed that software company that they must be trying to make a move. They sent you a bill already, right? Mm-hmm. Within a week's time, they sent a $40,000 bill? When did that ever happen?
Where did $40,000 come from? That's
part of they got a list of what all
they got started. A list of things that they did in that week.
Probably a lot of them.
That's unheard of.
Advance on the work that they had coming up.
$40,000 coming out of tax.
No, that's what we had to pay. Am I right, Bill? That's what we owe.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, it was work that they're going to be doing to get the transition from the old software to the new software. So yeah. Yeah.
I mean, I see that. I mean, they're charged, but we could have come back here and saved that money.
That was all part of it.
Just let it be noted at the tax.
Oh, you would love to have. You wouldn't be in the loan position. That's what we're here for. To protect.
Yeah.
To protect our citizens.
And
I'm here for
I don't make lucid decisions like that.
about taxpayer money. And when I find out how much it was going to cost us to go into this new software, it's just like I think, just, I think any individual here, if you need something at home.
We knew that cost before we agreed to go to the new.
Who knew the cost?
We did.
That was disgusting.
The four?
Yes, sir.
It was, I voted against it. I mean, that's on me. But, that's the way I feel about it. And I'm all for you being able to do your, and you know that.
Everybody, you know that. Everybody except for voted to go to the new software, knew what the cost is going to be.
Yes, we did, and I did. And Mr. Bill. We all knew it, but he made that. He wanted to look into it.
You could always make the statement that, well, let's just stay in the other room and save that $4,000. We all voted not to do that. We all voted to go to the new one because we were tired of the old one. We were going to be able to visit.
We, you said we.
I think you need to say that.
You said you tired of the old one.
We voted, I voted for that because Bill's requesting.